Welcome to 2J. This is the rational root theorem. So what is the rational root theorem? Well, it tells me that if P of X is a polynomial with integer coefficients, and if P over Q, so the fraction P over Q, is a zero of P of X, then P, little p, is a factor of the constant term of P of X, and Q is a factor of the leading coefficient of P of X. So the rational root theorem tells me my possible roots. So using the factors of the constant term and the leading coefficient of P of X, I can find possible zero solutions. So we use it to find all possible real roots and factors, and we use it to factor a difficult polynomial if no other information is given. So this first example, find the possible rational roots of the polynomial. So like my definition told me, I'm looking at my leading coefficient, which is my first coefficient, so 2x to the fourth. And I'm looking at my constant term, which is positive 9. So with my roots, I can always have positive or negative roots, as we have found. So I can have plus or minus any of these roots. So the factors of 9 I know are 1, 3, and 9. And the factors of 2 are just 1 and 2. So this is the idea of P over Q. P is my factors of 9. I'm looking at 9. And Q, I'm looking at 2. So I'm just going to break this up even further. So I'm going to get plus or minus 1 over 1. I'm going to go each term, so on the top. So 1 over 1, 3 over 1, 9 over 1, and then 1 over 2, 3 over 2, and 9 over 2. So when I simplify these, I get positive or minus 1, 3, 9, 1 half, 3 halves, or 9 halves. And so when I want to write them all out, I want to write the positive and the negative. So a positive 1, negative 1, positive 3, negative 3, positive 9, negative 9, positive 1 half, negative 1 half, positive 3 halves, negative 3 halves, and positive 9 halves, negative 9 halves. So these are all my possible rational roots to my polynomial. So this next question is just asking for me to find the actual roots of the polynomial. So now that I know that my roots, my possible roots are 1, negative 1, 3, negative 3, 9, negative 9, 1 half, negative 1 half, 3 halves, negative 3 halves, and 9 halves, and negative 9 halves, I'm either going to use the factor theorem or synthetic division to find which one of these are actual roots. So in this case, I want to find all the rational roots. I don't just want the possible ones. I want the actual roots to this polynomial. So the factor theorem tells me that when f of c equals 0, x equals c is a root, x minus c is a factor. And that's telling me the same thing. So if I'm looking at x equal to c, I want to see if the f of c is actually 0. So I'm going to start with x equals 1. I'm just going to start from the beginning. So I'm going to look at f of 1. And all I'm going to do is plug in 1 everywhere I see x. So 2 times 1 to the 4th plus 1 cubed minus 19, 1 cubed minus 9 times 1 plus 9. So I get 2 plus 1 minus 19 minus 9 plus 9. And when I simplify this, I get negative 16. So negative 16 is not equal to 0, so x equals 1 is not a root. So now I'm hoping that x equals negative 1. What I'm going to do is plug in negative 1 for x. So I take 2 times negative 1 to the 4th plus negative 1 cubed minus 19 negative 1 squared minus 9 times negative 1 plus 9. So when I simplify this, I get 2 minus 1 minus 19 plus 9 plus 9. And then when I simplify this all out, I actually get that this is equal to 0. So I know that x equals negative 1 is a root. The other way I can do this is with synthetic division. So if I'm looking at x equals, let's start with positive 3. X equals negative 3, and positive 3, I'm going to use synthetic division to find if it's a root or not. So I'm just going to take my coefficients, which are 2, 1, negative 19, negative 9, and 9. From my equation up here. I'm just taking my coefficients down. And I bring down my 2, take 2 times 3, which is 6. 1 plus 6 equals 7. 3 times 7 is 21. Negative 19 plus 21 is 2. 2 times 3 is 6. Negative 9 plus 6 is negative 3. And 3 times negative 3 is negative 9. So I get my remainder is 0. So this means x equals 3 is a root. So I'm going to go through this with all of my possible factors. So I would still have to test negative 3, 1 half, negative 1 half, 3 halves, negative 3 halves, 9 halves, and negative 9 halves. So I would have to test all of them. In order to find out my real roots. But I tested all of them before and I found out that x equals negative 1, negative 1 half, 3, and negative 3 were all possible rational roots. Now once I found my roots, I can use these to actually factor my equation. So if I was asked to factor the polynomial, as soon as I found my roots, I can easily factor this polynomial. So I'm given x equals 3, negative 3, negative 1, and negative 1 half. Now I can use synthetic division, like I did with the factor theorem, to further factor it, or I can just use my factors right here. So x equals 3, I subtract 3 to get this equal to 0, x equals negative 3, I add 3 to both sides, I get x plus 3, x equals negative 1, I add 1, I get x plus 1. And x equals negative 1 half. First, I'm going to multiply both sides by 2 to get 2x equals negative 1. And then I'm just going to add 1 to both sides to get 2x plus 1 equals 0. So altogether, my factors are x minus 3, x plus 3, x plus 1, and 2x plus 1. So these are all, when I put them all together, these are my factors, and when I would multiply this out, this would be my function. Like I said, you can use synthetic division, but if you're already given the factors, this is a nice, easy way for you to just factor it by itself. So this is the rational root theorem. The main things to know are how to find the actual roots, so p over q, the different values, and then then plugging them in, making sure that we can plug them in using the factor theorem or using synthetic division to make sure that our remainder is zero to find the actual roots. So this is it for factor theorem. Come to class with any questions you may have.